dear viewers and subscribers. The idea for this particular talk came from a paper I was editing for the literary journal Litcrit. It is a paper by Asha Balachandran on the Gujarati writer Himanshi Shelat's short story, The Door. It's about the protagonist yearning for a safe, clean and private toilet. And that set me thinking. I started looking for similar short stories or short fiction based on the same theme. And I couldn't find many stories. And what I did come up with was a lot of other interesting information which I wanted to share with you all. Now, when we look at the history of toilets in India, the first wet toilet, the kind of toilets that we use today, modern toilets, it was actually devised, developed and used in the Harappan civilization. From there, we come to a period, the modern period, where we have to have open defecation eradication campaigns. How did that happen? Over the centuries, a feeling of neglect or the belief that having toilets within the house is impure or it is because of superstitious beliefs, people started open defecation. And this has become more of a norm today. And we find that in this country, where sexual violence lurks around the corner, open defecation is actually very, very dangerous for most women and girls. And it is the same across India. In October 2014, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched his Swachh Bharat Abhiyan program to address sanitation issues and to make India open defecation free. More than 95 million toilet units were constructed across India. But we find that most of these toilets remained unused because of the superstitious beliefs or because of wrong sanitation beliefs among people or mainly because of the scarcity of water across India. So this is one of the basic human needs. It is an indispensable part of the human body. It is an indispensable human need to pass waste from the body, to remove waste from the body. And we take it for granted. We prefer not to discuss about such delicate issues. So one of the most blissful experiences in life, though hugely underrated, is to be able to relieve oneself in a safe, clean and private toilet. Virginia Woolf wrote A Room of One's Own. There are millions of girls and women across the world, especially in India, who are yearning for a toilet of their own. Rose George's book, The Big Necessity, is actually a very entertaining study about the whole issue of human waste disposal. And she says that women typically take about 90 seconds inside the toilet, while men need only 45 seconds. These statistics may vary, but we definitely take more time than men. Another thing is, women need slightly bigger toilets than men. There has to be a hook to hang a purse or bag or whatever. There has to be a shelf where you can keep a purse when you're carrying the sanitary pad. And there has to be a bucket, a mug, a little bit of soap. Now, these are not very big demands, but most employers, most public toilets prefer to ignore these needs. Typically, the urinals for men are smaller in size. They don't require such amenities, and men are not very particular about the safety or the cleanliness of toilets. So most employers prefer to do away with the construction of women-oriented toilets, and most public toilets are in a very pathetic state of disrepair, or they are extremely unsanitary and unsafe. So, in 19th century England, there was this organization called the Ladies Sanitary Association, which had to wage a stiff battle because they were demanding public toilets. And the lack of public toilets actually indicates the dismal levels of inclusivity of the female population of that particular country. Why were there so few public toilets in the past? Because women were confined to their homes, and patriarchy, it was basically a patriarchal conspiracy to keep women confined to the kitchen or the four walls of the house. See, when women move out, naturally toilets are required, and so if toilets were absent, then it would prevent women from traveling? Now, these are various issues which are addressed in several books written in different parts of India. So there are toilet wars raging across India, and toilets have been the site of gender wars and caste wars across India. While I was searching for short stories, I came across so many real life stories of a revolution being set off by the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, with girls and women across different parts of India waging their own private, individual, silent battles, demanding safe, clean, private toilets. Now, researching a short story led me to so many other stories. I read about the poop guy, a man who left his job in the United States in order to address the problem of human waste disposal in India. There are several such stories across India. Stella Paul is a journalist from northeastern India who is committed to writing about the marginalized, underprivileged communities across India. She is somebody who has dedicated her life to writing those stories which will probably never appear in mainstream media. And she writes about the dangers or the perils of writing about toilets in India. Once she was talking to a group of Dalit women in Hamirpur, somewhere in northern India, about toilets, about the sexual harassment they faced at their work site, which was an illegal mine site. And while they were talking, a group of men came and they assaulted the women because they had dared to think or talk about toilets. And they were not supposed to do that because they were Dalit women. So you see, toilets are sites of gender wars. They are sites of caste wars. And they are not a structure that is essential for a human being, or especially a woman or a girl, to pass urine or to defecate in the privacy of a safe, clean, four-walled structure. Basically, what most women and girls across India need is a toilet that is safe, that is clean, and that is private, which will ensure their dignity, privacy, and safety. Because India is a country where sexual violence is lurking right around the corner. Two girls were raped, murdered, and hanged from a tree because they had gone out to defecate or pass urine out in the open. So this is a danger that stalks every girl, every woman in India who is forced every day to go out either in the daytime or at night to answer nature's call, a very basic need of every human being. My next talk will be on two stories that I managed to find on this particular theme. Thank you.